So the fun continues as people come to my website and have discussions with my FAQ chatbot, including this person that decided to have a little bit of fun. But that's not the reason for this video, right? In reviewing some of these responses, I actually became aware of some chatbot builder functionality that I was not aware of previously. And, you know, my chatbot here does a pretty good job of not responding to this individual. But let's look at this functionality. And maybe this is even the same person just coming back for more. But anyways, what is this? This is a conversation that is in a completely different language. You can see that my assistant opens up in English. Welcome to Umbral. How can I help you today? And the individual immediately starts talking in what appears to be French. Okay. So what happens in order to test out to see what this response is? Let's look at this conversation because I obviously cannot read French. We will enlist our good friend GPT-40. Claude also does a great job, but GPT-40 is really fast, which is why I want to see this. Translate the following conversation into English. Identify the two speakers. Speaker one is Umbri, which is a name that I give to my assistant. Speaker two is random internet friend. For formatting, speaker should be on H2. And I'll paste the conversation and let's see what we get here. There we go. Welcome to Umbral, which is what we saw. In what way can you create dynamic chatbots? We create dynamic chatbots using tools like Voicelo, Chatbot Builder, and BotPress, depending on the required features. We also integrate various automation tools, such as BuildShip and A&M, make Zapier to meet specific client needs. What a wonderful response, Umbri, who is now speaking in French. And we scroll through here, and we have a great conversation. Okay. Now, this person continues to push and push and push and ask more and more. And I do have a response that I don't love, which Umbri makes up some information on me selling a chatbot for $20,000, which is not true. That has not happened. But that's something that's good feedback for me to go and adjust my prompting and make sure something like that doesn't happen again, which is why I love putting these bots on my website because I am gathering data. But anyways, back to the French speaking aspect of this. What did I do in order to allow Umbri to speak French? Any guesses? The answer is nothing. Okay. This is once again, baked in functionality. And if I scroll up again, I have another conversation and somebody wants to speak to me in Spanish. And I'm thinking there is a chance that this might be the same person that is hitting me up over and over again, but if I come back to GPT, right, same thing. Here we go, in Spanish. I'm sorry, I can only answer relevant questions to Umbral and AI solutions in English. So we have another conversation that is happening fully in Spanish. So now I'm multilingual, French and Spanish, answering questions, which is awesome. But here is the third example where I was like, whoa, this is pretty slick. Now this is very, very nice functionality on the surface, but here's the level up in my opinion. If I keep scrolling up, now I think this is a different person. This is in Chinese lettering here. What's going on here? Again. Normal back and forth. This is what we do. Let's wait for it. Go out. Okay. I want to start a project. Great. To book a discovery call, full name, email address, preferred date and time. So this is a function call to link up to my Google Calendar that I've made on the back end. And it is talking in Chinese with this function call, and it books an appointment with this particular individual. Now, this is, I do not believe, is a legit email address. And this is, once again, the person just pushing the boundary of this to see this, because you can see he's saying the first one, the second one. He's trying to bait the chatbot into various responses, which is, once again, fine. But I'm very glad this conversation existed, because I can now book appointments, multilingual, without doing anything else. This Chinese character interaction, having a conversation, booking a discovery call, is baked in to the responses of Chatbot Builder. I feel like I'm a broken record right now with this baked in functionality. This is huge. This is strong. I don't need to set up different assistants for multilingual. I don't have to create this button to speak to me in English, to speak to me in French, and then route through some different logic. I don't have to have a set AI step where I say, determine this language and then act in a particular way. I don't have to create a bot in English from the drop-down menu at the start and think about this. It's just working. Now, if you were to create and drag a text block that's hard text on there and put it in English, it's going to respond in English. But I'm sure that after poking and prodding around here some more, then can probably find a solution for that as well. This is awesome. Thank you, random internet friends, for hitting up this FAQ chatbot and letting me know that this functionality is available and natively embedded and ready to go out of the box. This was quite the successful experiment for me. So anyways, multilingual chatbots with little to no effort out of the box. Chatbot Builder strikes again. Good job. Love to know what y'all think. Talk to you soon. Happy building.